Hello students, welcome to the English literature class. In today's class, we shall take up the second poem of your literature book, Beehive, that is Wind. This poem is written by famous South Indian poet Subramanya Bharathi. However, he had written in Tamil language, and it was translated by A.K. Ramanujan. So the poem we have in our book is the English translation version. So this poem basically is a pre-verse poem. That means it does not follow a particular rhyme scheme or rhyme words. So students, the main theme of the poem is that to be strong before the challenges. In our human life, we face every time different kinds of challenges, problems and difficulties. And what we feel? We feel frightened. We feel like running away from the challenges and problems. But the poet is telling us through this poem that if we become weaker, we show that we fail to face the challenges, then we lose. We are defeated, we are crushed, we are destroyed. But when we face the challenges strongly, boldly, bravely, then we become more brave, more strong, and we succeed in our life. This is the main message of the poem. So let us see line by line, stanza by stanza. I have categorized into three stanzas. Let us take up the poem stanza wise. So in the first stanza, the poet says to the wind, "Wind, come softly. Don't break the shutters of the windows. Don't scatter the papers. Don't throw down the books on the shelf. There, look what you did. You threw them all down. You tore the pages of the books. You brought rain again. You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings." The poet tells the wind that please come softly, move slowly, so that you don't break the shutters, you don't break the windows, you don't break the houses which are built poorly. Look what you have done with your storm blowing. The books have fallen down from the shelves and the pages have been torn. And look, you bring the rain also. Rain is good, but when you bring too much rain, it is a curse for us. But you are to give only sufficient amount of rain. But when you bring too much rain, it is very harmful for us. So this is what the poet asked the rain. Poet asked the wind to do. Let's move to the second stanza. The poet says, "You are very clever at poking fun at weaklings, frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. He won't do what you tell him. So come, let's build strong homes. Let's join the doors firmly. Practice to firm the body. Make the heart steadfast." So this is what the poet tells us, that he tells the wind that you are very good at disturbing and destroying the weak people. You are destroying, crumbling means making them weaker. Destroying who? Destroying the houses of the poor people. destroying their doors, destroying their rafters, supports of the houses, destroying the wood, destroying the bodies, their physical bodies, destroying their lives, the entire living mechanism, destroying their hearts and minds. And poet says, look, Winnowed, you are winnowing and crushing the poor people. Winnowing means you are separating, you are destroying the weaker ones and completely bringing their end. Whereas the stronger ones, they survive and they become stronger. So what good you are doing? You are doing only harm to the poor people. So please do come softly and spare the poor people. So poet still finds that wind does not listen to our request. When the poet sees that wind does not listen to his request, that wind should come slowly, wind should move slowly, then he tells us something else, how to overcome the wind. So let's come to the third stanza. In the third stanza, the poet is advising us. What is the advice? Do this and the wind will be friends with us. What we should do? The wind blows out big fires. He makes strong fires roar and flourish. His friendship is good. We praise him every day. So, the poet says, so be strong. Make your homes strong. Make your doors firmly, strongly, so that strong wind also cannot break. Make our body strong, so that wind cannot destroy us, cannot weaken us. Make our hearts and minds steadfast. Make ourselves strong, brave. Let us face the wind strongly. Let us face the challenges strongly. And then we shall be able to face the wind strongly. That's why he says, let us do this and we'll find that wind will be friend with us. And when we see the wind coming, it will blow out the weak only. But when we become strong, it cannot blow us out. It cannot destroy us. So only the weak will be lost, whereas the strong will flourish, strong will emerge to be stronger, strong people will win. So let us become strong and win against the power of the wind. So be friend and praise the wind to make us strong. So if we become strong, wind cannot destroy us. And instead, the positive aspect of this strong wind is that we will learn to be strong and we will stand strongly and face the challenges. And for that, let us thank and praise the wind. Dear students, the lesson we learned from this poem is that in this world, we have to be strong. Then only we can face the challenges. More we become strong, we will emerge stronger. More we become weak, we will become weaker, we will be destroyed. So this is the summary and explanation of the poem. Now students, let us see how the poet has used different devices. Literary devices the poet has used. First of all, anaphora. Anaphora means the poet has used few lines starting with the same words. For example, the poet has used the line number 2, 3, 4 starting with don't. Don't break, don't scatter, don't throw. And again, you tore, you brought, you are very clever. This is starting the sentences with the same words. It's called anaphora. Secondly, the poet has used personification. Personification, you know, that when we describe any non-living thing, inanimate thing, as person, as human being, then we say it is the personification. and the whole poem has been used as personification, and the poet has used the wind as human being. Then poet has used the repetition. Repetition means repeating certain clauses, sentences, lines again and again. For example, crumbling houses, crumbling roads, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling hearts. These are repeated, and that is the repetition. Then symbolism. Symbolism is the device through which the poet wants to convey strong message, symbol, sign. In fact, this wind is symbolizing the problems, difficulties, challenges. And so, it is a symbol in our life that wind is symbol for us, that it is the challenge and problem in our life. Then, alliteration. Alliteration means certain words in the same line appearing in a close sequence. For example, strong fire, road, flourish, like a fire, flourish, starting with F. And wind god, we know W, wind, W, we know. So this is the literally devices. So students, I hope you understood the summary and explanation, the literary devices and the deep message that is conveyed through this poem. So in today's lesson, that's all. Thank you.